is most important to God? Because when we look at in Proverbs, when we look at the book of Proverbs and we talk about the virtuous woman and it talks about all of these things that she does, the book concludes by saying, beauty is fleeting and charm is deceptive, but a woman that fears the Lord is to be praised. That is what is most important to God. Do you, as a woman, fear the Lord? Even in your homes, in your marriages, when your husband is being a hothead and all of that, look to him as though you were serving the master. That makes it easier. God says, be comfortable in the role that I've given you. God has given each and every one roles to play. Your child is not going to rise up and say, I'm the father in the house. He should remain a child until he gets to his own home, and then he becomes a father. The daughter has no right to rise up in the home and say, I'm going to be a wife now to my father. Your daughter cannot become a wife. God has placed us in different roles, and each of these roles he recognizes. Let the Bible be your guide. People say, we didn't ask to come to this world. I didn't ask to be somebody's daughter or whatever. And they say that for everything in life, there's a manual. But for life, there's no manual. Is that true? That's a lie of the devil. We've been given a manual. When you buy stuff, hallelujah, it comes with a manual. And manual, when you look at the meaning of the word manual, it actually talks about you going into the mind of the man who created that thing. He wants you to think, to have what he had in mind when he was. So he tells you how to operate it. He puts all of that in the manual. And the manual is usually placed right at the top. So that's the thing you take out first. But most of the time, we get out something and we throw the manual away. And then when we begin to struggle, we are like, oh, this thing does not work. Did you look at the manual? No. Why not ask the maker? He provided a manual. And do you know that's what the world does today? You go meet counselors of the world. They call them shrinks. Am I right? Am I using the right word? They call them shrinks. Hallelujah. And you want counseling from people who don't even know better. They don't know anything. You run into problems in life and you go meet people who are clueless. And you actually pay these people. You go meet a psychologist or whatever they are called who has been married 3 times and you tell them that you are struggling in your home and you want them to give you the recipe for a perfect home. Praise the Lord. The world wants you to forget about God. Why not meet the maker? He made you. Ask him, Lord, how do you want me to function? You want a good home, is in there. You want to be a good wife, is in there. The Bible tells you, a wise woman builds her house, but a foolish one tears it down. But the world tells you, stand up for your right as a woman. The Bible says, submit to your husband. The world says, stand up for your rights. And at the end of the day, you guys are headed for the divorce court. And you're wondering, what have I done wrong? The Bible says, don't be unaware of the devices of the devil. Meet the maker. When some of the disciples, you know, Jesus had several of them, and they had said something, Jesus had said something he didn't like, and many of them left him. And Jesus was like, what about you? Are you guys still here with me? Why don't you leave? Don't you want to leave? And they said, Master, where should we go? You are the one that has the answer to eternal life. God is the one who has the answer to everything you may think of. You are having struggles with your children. You want to know the right way to bring them up. Go to the manual. You want to know how to deal with your colleagues. Go to the manual. You want to know how to be a good child. Go to the manual. It's all there. But some people will not touch this book, not even to save their lives.